Love is in the air. Hey, crazy crafters, my name is Michael, and we are making a super cute Valentine's Day accent lamp out of this little red mailbox right here. It came from the Target dollar spot for literally just a dollar. But of course, I couldn't help but to wonder how cute this would be as a Valentine's Day accent lamp. So that's exactly what we're making today. I hope you have your crafty pants on because it is time to get crafty. You guys, I am dying to find out what you think of how this turned out.
All right, boys, how to spoil your girl for Valentine's Day. First thing you need is a stuffed animal. A huge one. I'm getting this one. Super important. You need chocolate. Grabbing this one. Also this one. This one's cute, so this one as well. A cute vase for flowers. You need flowers for the vase. Don't forget the card, boys. I'm getting her this one. I'm also going to get decorations to decorate her room. If you love her, get her more chocolate. Come back on Valentine's Day to see her reaction.
Well, I found a woman stronger than anyone. Shares my dreams, I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found a love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own.
Mala. And now you kicking and screaming a big toddler. Don't try to get your friends to come holler. Holler. Ayo, I used to lay low. I wasn't in the clubs, I was on my J.O. Until I realized you had...
We're gonna make easy DIY crayons perfect for Valentine's Day. First, you'll need some crayons and take all the paper off. You'll need a silicone baking mold, toothpicks, a cutting board, and a knife. You wanna chop the crayons into bits and then fill your mold. I ran out of red, but I'm gonna use some purple and that'll give it a really cool marble look. Next, you'll bake this in the oven at 200 degrees until it's all melted, which is about 10 minutes. Once they're all melted, we're gonna let them cool. Before the mold's completely dry, you'll want to add the toothpicks to the corner, and I'm using the flat side down. You'll want to swirl them a little bit to make sure they went all the way through. Then continue to let these dry until fully hardened. Once dry, remove and pop the toothpicks out. Simply tie with ribbon or twine to any Valentine, and they're ready to go.
Valentine's been taking hearts of mine and think that Cupid's up to something. You ask me how I feel, I say nothing. Someone give me some paper, someone give me some crayons. I'm feeling like a child, I need something to...
Love wants you, we can bring it on the floor. Never danced like this before. We don't talk about it, dance on.
Watch the sunset, kinda, yeah, yeah. Rolling eyes back in my head, make my toes curl, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy.
Same recipe as last time, you'll need a bowl.
1 cup of baking soda.
1/2 cup of citric acid, you can get that at Walmart.
1/2 cup of cornstarch.
And 1/2 cup of Epsom salt.
Mix all of that together.
Set that aside and grab another bowl.
You'll need 1 teaspoon of water.
Sorry about the background noise, that's Bean. 2 teaspoons of coconut oil. Now add in your fragrance. You can either use essential oils or soap fragrances.
I'm going to use strawberry because it's Valentine's Day themed.
Mix all of that together. Slowly add it to the dry mixture and make sure you stir right away. Your mixture should look like this, and if it doesn't, just add water, but it should be to where you can hold a shape in your hand but still be able to break it apart. This part is optional, but I separated the mixture into different bowls so that I can add color. You can either use mica powder or soap colorant. These are my colors, now it's time for the mold. I also added mica glitter to some of them. I'm really excited for this black. Now they just need to set. I'm gonna stick them in the freezer to speed up that process.
I don't have a lot of time left, so I'll see you in an hour to show you what they look like.
Well now, really, when we go back then to falling in love and say it's crazy, falling. You see, we don't say rising into love. There is in it the idea of the fall. And goes back, as a matter of fact, to extremely fundamental things.
Oh, some oh, look at them. I really like this rock.
चाहे गवाए चांद तारे हैं न समझो अजनबी सदियों से हम तो बस तुम्हारे हैं मोहब्बत से नहीं तेरे पास मैं आऊंगा मैं भी तेरा दीवाना हूँ दूर से ही मनाऊंगा
I just wanna write a song about a boy and a girl. Junkies on the corner always calling my name, and the kids on the corner playing ghetto games. When I saw you getting down, girl, I hope it was you. And when I look into your eyes, I knew it was true. I said, hey.
This one's for the sprinkle lovers. I'm making a small funfetti cake with 3 6-inch cake layers. I'm adding a pretty generous layer of frosting, a ton of sprinkles between each cake layer, and then I'm crumb coating the cake. I chilled this in the freezer for 10 minutes to let it get nice and firm, and then I added a bunch of different frosting to the side. It's a bunch of different colors so that when I make the stripes, they all kind of blend together, and it looks kind of cool, kind of pretty, right? I smoothed this out, then I cut out a heart-shaped pattern with parchment paper, added a ton of sprinkles to it, and then made little hearts all around the cake. Then it was time to mix all my frostings together. I piped a bunch of lines with those different pink frostings, rolled them together like a little frosting sausage, cut it, shoved it in a frosting bag, and made some pretty multicolored swirls. And then our cake was complete. I added some more sprinkles for good measure, cut in, and then did a little taste test. If you're alone this Valentine's Day, don't worry, just make some cake like me.
I normally don't do these videos, but I decided to show you guys how I made my boyfriend's Valentine's Day gift. So I got this little box. It was from the thrift store for like $1, and I painted it red, and then I painted the lid as well because why not? And then after that, I let it dry, and I got this jar from the dollar store that had date nights on it, and I wrote a bunch of date nights, and then I took a little break after I did that, and I painted more layers onto the box. And then after that, I finished the date nights and got those out of the way. And then I also ended up cutting out some pictures of us, and I arranged them on the little lid of the box, and I Mod Podged them and glued them onto that as well, which did not take long at all, actually. I don't know how I did it so fast. And then I went over with another layer of Mod Podge and let that dry, and then I put this stuff in from the dollar store, and then I put all this stuff in, and that is it. I really hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope you get some ideas, and I love how it turned out.
It comes alive at midnight. My mama doesn't trust him. He's only here for one thing, but... Watch the sunset, kinda, yeah, yeah. Rolling eyes back in my head, make my toes curl, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Say the word.
Engagement ring. You can get an engagement ring from Poundland. Guess how much it is? It's £1. Do you have to tell the person that you propose to that you only spent £1 on the engagement ring or not?